Hey, how's everybody doing today? My name's Sam Angello, and I hope you're having a terrific day. Today, we're going to talk about how to create a static lower third for your Blackmagic switcher. So before we start today, I have a big favor to ask you. Can you please make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe. Also, make sure to follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook so you can stay up to date when we post new videos. So before I start today's video, I want to go over some questions we have been getting on our animated lower third video we put out there a couple weeks ago. So the first question we have been getting is, what file format do I save my image sequence as? I use PNG plus Alpha. So the next question we've been getting asked a lot is, how come I can't import my image sequence into my Blackmagic video switcher? Well, the biggest answer I found out how come most people have been experiencing issues doing this is they don't have a video switcher that supports it. So for you to be able to do that, you need to have this clip section up here. You can't import the image sequence into the stills. You have to import it into the media pool clip section. Now to check to see if your video switcher can do this, you can go to the Blackmagic website and I'll show you how to do that right now. So once you go to the Blackmagic website, the first thing you're going to want to do is go to where it says products, click on products. Then you're going to want to go to the video switcher tab right here, click on that. Then you're going to want to choose the video switcher section. We're going to click on it. Then we're going to come up here to where it says technical specs. We're going to click on that. We're going to choose the switcher we own. And then we're going to scroll down to the media player section, which is right here. And then we're going to look for media pool clips. And that will tell you if your switcher is capable of handling doing an animated lower third like I showed in my example. So the last question we've been getting is, how do I do a still image lower third or a static lower third? So I'm going to show you how to do that right now. The first thing you need to do is go to your media tab in your switcher and then locate the still image you want to use. So as you can see, I have mine right here. And we're going to drag that into our still section, media player one, and we're going to load that up. Then we're going to switch back to our video switching tab. So now that you're on your switcher tab, you're going to go to upstream key one. Once you're in upstream key one, we're going to choose our fill source, which is going to be media player one. And then our key source is going to automatically populate for you, and that's going to be media player one key. Now that we've done that, we can go and we can activate our static image lower third. So now that we have our upstream key all set up, it's ready to go. All we need to do is click our on air button and you'll see our lower third appear. 1, 2, 3. So as you can see, making a static lower third is very easy and they can be powerful and look just as cool as having an animated lower third. For more questions on this, feel free to ask them in the comment section below. If you're interested in any of the equipment I'm using, I'll put a link to all that in the description below as well. And most importantly, remember to give this video a big thumbs up, share it with your friends, and subscribe. Dream big, think bigger, and always be you.